Hi, my name's Jeff Turner. I'm the Riverkeeper for the Blackwater Nottoway Rivers. I guess y'all know what this is. Yes. And if you don't, well, this is Moon Pie. She's the co-pilot. So we're going to take y'all on a trip today, show you some wildlife and some beautiful scenery on the Blackwater Nottoway Rivers. So put on your life preserver and hold on, and we'll get going.
Snake! This big brown water snake is often misidentified as a cottonmouth. In 1975, on the Nottoway, just outside of Rangut, my dad and I saw one that was 7 foot long and as big around as a quart jar. It's the biggest snake I've ever seen on the river. I've got a picture to back that up too. Females give birth live from 16 to 63, yes, 63 baby creepy crawly snakes. Check out this big old snapping turtle catching some rays. I bet he had a hard time getting up there, but not a hard time getting off. These are immature black crowned night herons. They are primarily fish eaters. These are the only two I have ever seen, and both of them were seen within 2 weeks of each other. Raccoons are very good swimmers, and I have seen many over the years crossing the rivers. Me and Moon Pie followed this one closely, just to make sure it made it to the other side safely. Big Bad Leeward Brown, the biggest, baddest beaver in the whole town. Well, at least that's what Moon Pie named this big fella. The American Indians called the beaver the sacred center of the land because this species creates rich habitats for other creatures by building dams. Ah, there's nothing like a good scratch after munching on a tasty tree. Adults can reach 50 pounds, and old Leroy here is at least that. 1 to 4 kits are born in the spring, and they stay with the parents for up to 2 years. Beaver really don't eat wood, but cut trees to get at the bark and tender leaves, then use the wood for construction. I'm not sure if Leroy here had eyesight problems or what. He never paid Moon Pie and I much attention, and seemed to enjoy his time being in the spotlight. Moon Pie does her part to clean up the rivers also. Here she is making sure this dead fish gets a proper burial. Moon Pie is very dedicated and takes her job very seriously, as you can see here. Good job, Moon Pie. Now please, go wash your face. I was very lucky to catch the Blackwater Eagles during their courtship flight. At the protected nest site near Cherry Grove, their nest was almost destroyed during Hurricane Isabel. But they rebuilt the damaged nest the following year and successfully raised 3 chicks. Eggs hatch in 5 to 6 weeks and chicks fledge at about 12 weeks. Eagles mate for life. Crazy doesn't begin to describe these next scenes. We thought the little fawn was stranded under this tree, but found it didn't need our help at all. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the second film about our two great rivers. All these things you have just seen are the reasons why the Blackwater Nottoway Riverkeeper program exists in the first place. It is our responsibility to protect and preserve these two wonderful resources we call the Blackwater and Nottoway Rivers. Godspeed, Mother Nature.